Trump has brought in a member of his team, and in fact, she's actually been with the Trump team for years and years, has kind of come and gone every now and then, but she is back, woman by the name of Susie Wiles. And the New York Times did a very lengthy, for some reason, piece on Susie Wiles. Who is she? What has she done? Why does she matter? And why is she back on Trump's team? Well, the answer is actually quite simple. Susie Wiles used to be one of the top advisors for Florida Governor Ron DeSantis until the two of them had a falling out. DeSantis fired Wiles after he said that she was leaked and influence peddled at the governor's expense when she was on his team. So that doesn't seem like a very trustworthy person. So why would Trump bring this person onto his camp? Well, Roger Stone said it best. She knows where the bodies are buried. So Donald Trump has brought Susie Wiles back onto his team because he believes she's got the dirt on Ron DeSantis. She also, by the way, at least at one point, not sure if she still is, but she was the CEO of Trump's Save America Political Action Committee. She worked on his campaign in 2016. She worked on his campaign in 2020. She also is the one who encouraged him to endorse Blake Masters for Senate, and that didn't end well for Trump. And she also worked for John Huntsman's failed 2012 presidential campaign. So the endorsement of Masters, the firing by Ron DeSantis for alleged influence peddling, she worked for Trump in 2020 when he lost. She worked for him in 2016 when he didn't win the popular vote. She worked for Huntsman's failed campaign. Like, I just see a lot of failures in her past, like her very recent past. So it does seem kind of weird. Like, Donald, you're bringing in a woman who's kind of helped you lose a lot. And when she wasn't helping you lose, she was actually helping other people lose. And by the way, the only reason she even worked for Ron DeSantis in the first place is because Donald Trump basically told Ron, you have to bring her in. So is she going to be the one to tell Trump where the bodies are buried with Ron DeSantis? Is she going to be the missing piece of the puzzle that helps Donald take down Ron? Who knows? All I know is that this Republican primary is getting very stupid very quickly. It's also getting very exhausting, and we only have like 3-4 candidates at this point. And one of the people we have to talk about the most is somebody who technically hasn't even declared that he is running yet, and that is Ron DeSantis. But if Trump wants to take down DeSantis, I mean, to be honest, not that I want to help Trump, you're already doing a good job of it. I mean, let's be real, credit where credit is due. He's doing a good job. DeSantis is falling in the polls. DeSantis's culture war issues do not play well in America. DeSantis went to Washington, D.C. yesterday, and according to the reports, the reception was not warm. Nobody outside of Florida seems to like him. So he doesn't really have a shot at making it to the White House. You don't need to hire this, you know, serial loser, for as far as I can see, to come into your campaign and give you all the dirt on him. All the dirt on Ron DeSantis is pretty much known. We all know how horrible he is, and the public is reacting to that. So maybe you could save yourself some money, and instead of hiring somebody who knows where the bodies are buried, you could, I don't know, read the news and get all the dirt you need on Ron DeSantis.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.